Heinz has built a brand known all around the globe.
But its legacy started right here in Pittsburgh just 4 years after the Civil War ended. Action News anchor Sally Wiggin takes us back in time. It's fascinating stuff.
Oh, yeah, you should be at the History Center. It was fabulous. The best place to get that look is, guys, at the Heinz History Center. But the company's exhibit, one of the museum's most popular, is being revamped and is not even on display. But we got a behind-the-scenes tour of all things Heinz, even in the archives.
H.J. Heinz is born here. His parents are both German immigrants. He takes his mother's love of cooking and his German heritage, and he turns it into a product, horseradish.
A company in Sharpsburg followed, and when it went bankrupt, Henry J. Heinz founded another with his brother and cousin.
By 1888, he's bought them out. He's founded the H.J. Heinz Company. Quickly, he begins to globalize his company in the 1880s.
He actually made his first foreign sale in 1886, and in 1896 came up with a famous 57 varieties, even though there were well over 60.
Saw a shoe store that advertised 21 different kinds of shoes, and it stuck with him, a number that could represent, that would stick in the American mind and would say something about his product.
And he took pride in the purity of his product.
He was very involved in 1906 in the passage of the Pure Food and Drug Law. He believed that people should know what was in their food.
His son Howard guided the company through the Great Depression, and his grandson Jack took over after that. It was during Jack's time as CEO that the late Senator John Heinz made a decision that would impact the history of Pennsylvania.
The senator starts his career on the factory floor. I mean, he grows into that company and decides he's really better suited for public life.
During the next several decades, the company became a global giant, and men outside the family became its CEOs. But always the company that made Pittsburgh proud stayed true to a slogan from its founder.
He used to say, "Do a common thing uncommonly well," was his motto.
What a motto. By the way, the Heinz exhibit will be open again in April, probably late April, with an added attraction, that impressive purchase price. And you know, guys, it's funny. People who come from out of town think it's the ketchup museum.
Right.
Yeah.
And they think they're going to the ketchup museum.
No.
And then when they get there, they think everything inside the museum is owned by the Heinz family. But there's so much more in that museum.
It is such a cool place.
Oh, it is. It's fabulous. Kids love it.
Now a new chapter.
Yeah, thanks.
And this is great because we also have a complete slideshow of the history of Heinz and all of its products. It's on our website, WTAE.com. You got to swing by. Click on the story. It's in the top story box. You'll find it at the top of the homepage.